Okay, let's look at adding and subtracting fractions, and we're going to use the pattern blocks again. Just to review, these are the shapes that we're going to be working with. The yellow hexagon equals one whole, red trapezoid represents one half, the blue rhombus represents one third, and the green triangle represents one sixth. Okay, let's go ahead and start with our red trapezoid, that's one half. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna present the model and then write out the equation, okay? And so first we're gonna start with one half, okay? And we're gonna add to that one half. So one half plus one half. And likely you're going to know that that's going to equal one whole, but if we before we reduce it to one whole, really what we have is two one-half pieces, and we would write that as 2 seconds or two halves, okay? And we know that when we reduce that, that becomes one, okay? Now what if we had two halves, okay? And we're going to add to that one more half. Okay, one half. Two halves plus one half, well, that's going to be three halves. One, two, three. So three halves. And we, of course, know that that's one and one half, because we could substitute these two halves for one, and this would be one and one half. Okay. All right, let's just keep going, and then we'll talk more about what's going on here. Let's go ahead and work with some triangles. Say I have 1/6, okay, and I'm going to add to that 3/6. Okay, so 1/6 plus 3/6. How many do I have? I have four. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4/6. Okay, and I could reduce that, but let's just focus on what's going on here, and then we can reduce later. Okay, let's say we have 2/6, okay, 2/6, and I want to add to that 5/6, so 5/6. So let me get these on the paper. There's 2, 3, 4, and then 5. So how many sixths do I have? Well, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have 7/6. And yes, I know I can convert that to a mixed number, but we're not focusing on that right now. All right, let's say I have 1/6, and I'm going to add to that 2/6. Okay, so I'm going to add two more. How many does that equal altogether? Well, there's three of them, so there's 3/6. Okay, let's go ahead and do another. Let's say we have we could say this represents one and one sixth, or how about 7/6? Let's just call that 7/6. And we're going to add to that 3 more sixths. Okay, 3/6. So how many sixths do we have? Well, this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10/6. All right, let's work with some rhombuses. Let's say we have a third, one third, and we're going to add to that one more third. How many thirds do we have? We have 2/3. Okay. Let's say we have 3/3 altogether, 3/3. And we're going to add 2 more thirds, 2/3. How many thirds do we have? Looks like we have 5/5. Okay, now we can keep going with addition. Let's go ahead and do some subtraction problems. And I'll move the paper up. So let's say let's go back to sixths. Let's say we have five of those sixths. Okay, there's 5/6. And we're going to take away 2/6. So instead of adding on, I'm just going to take 2 and move them off the paper. So how many are left? Oops. How many are left on that paper? Looks like 3. 3/6. Okay. All right. Let's say we've got 3/3. 3/3. And I'm going to take away 1/3. How many thirds are left? 2/3. Okay, and let's go ahead and do one more. Let's say we have, we'll do an improper fraction here. Let's say we have 5/2. Okay, 5/2. And I'm gonna take away 4/2. Okay, so here's 4, and I'll bring it down here. How many are left? 1/2. Yeah. Okay, now let's go back and look at, see if we see any patterns here. We're not going to use the pattern blocks. We're just going to look at the numbers, and let's see if you can let's see if we can come up with an idea of what's going on here. So for adding, notice that the answer, so we'll look at the numerators and the denominators. And let's first look at the denominators. When we have 1/2 plus 1/2, our denominator is also in 1/2, okay? So all of these are the same. When we were working with sixths, 1/6 plus 3/6, we get 4/6. So again, the denominators are all the same. Here, when we're working with thirds, 1/3 plus 1/3 equals 2/3. Again, the denominator reflects the denominators that are being used in the addition problem. Now, this is also going to be the case when we are working with subtraction. Sixths, and sixths. Here we've got 3/3 minus 1/3 equals 2/3. So again, the denominators are the same. And the last one, we're working 5/2 minus 4/2 equals 1/2. They're all the same. Okay? And so what we're dealing with here in all of these examples, we have common denominators. And common is going to mean same. Okay? They're the same. All of them are 2s, all of them are 6s, or all of them are 3s. Okay, now let's look at our numerators and see what's going on with the numerators. Now in this first one, when we had 1/2 plus 1/2, our numerator was not 1. But it looks like we're adding the numerators. 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay? So we're adding. Here, let's look at this one. Here we have 2/2 plus 1/2. We get 3/2. So what we're doing is we're adding 2 plus 1. So we're adding the numerators, and we get that new numerator, or the sum of those added numerators is what's going to be reflected in our answer. When we're working with 6, it's the same thing. 1 plus 3 is 4, so we're just adding. And here 2 plus 5, that's going to be 7. Now granted, this is an improper fraction and we would change it to a mixed number, but you know, that's just an additional step you can take. Initially, what you're going to be doing though is adding those numerators up when your denominators are the same. Here, when we have thirds, 1/3 plus 1/3 is 2/3, we're adding those up. Now let's look at the subtraction examples. We had 5/6 minus 2/6. Well, 5 minus 2 is going to give us 3. And so, again, we're just taking what's in the numerators and doing the operation. So we've got 5 minus 2. Here we have 3 minus 1 is going to give us 2. And 5 minus 4 is going to give us 1. Okay. So when the denominators are the same, we're going to take the numerators. The numerators are going to follow the operation. So when denominators are the same, the numerators will complete the operation. So without models, if I say I have 3/7 plus 2/7, my denominator is going to be a 7, and I'm going to add the 3 and the 2, and that would give me 5/7. For subtraction, if I had 9/10 minus 5/10, okay, my denominator would be 10, and I would just subtract 5 from 9. So 9 minus 5 is 4, 4/10. And again, we could reduce that, but this initially, what we're doing is if the denominators are the same, okay, then we're just going to do the operation, or the numerators will just do the operation. So 9 minus 5 is 4, 4/10. Okay, well, this will be the case for adding and subtracting with common denominators. In the next video, we'll talk about uncommon denominators and what we have to do to complete those problems.